Good morning. Mayor, welcome everyone to the second meeting in 2022 of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee, which is taking place fully online. Before we move to the first agenda item, with again meeting today online, it will be more challenging for members to indicate agreement to the items being discussed. I therefore ask you to raise your hand if you are not content with the instrument being put, or if you wish to speak about an instrument. The first item of business is to decide whether to take items 6, 7, 8 and 9 in private. Is the committee content to take these items in private? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Moving to agenda item number 2, we are considering an instrument laid under the European Union Withdrawal Act 2018. The committee is considering if the appropriate scrutiny procedure and the appropriate category has been applied to SSI 2021-493, the official controls, transitional staging period, miscellaneous amendments, Scotland No. 3, Regulations 2021. This instrument relates to the start date, in which imports of animal products and certain plants, plant products and other objects to Scotland from EU, EEA and related countries will be subject to additional requirements. It has been laid under the negative procedure and is considered by the Scottish Government to be of low significance. Is the committee content that the appropriate scrutiny procedure and categorisation have been applied to this instrument? But no member has indicated that they are not content to speak, and so we are agreed. Under agenda item we're considering instruments subject to the made affirmative procedure. Issues have been raised on SSI 2022-2, the Health Protection, Coronavirus, International Travel and Operator Liability, Scotland Amendment Regulations 2022. The instrument amends the requirements and restrictions affecting international travellers arriving in Scotland. A number of issues have been raised on the instrument. I'll cover each in turn. Firstly, Regulation 7 of the instrument amends the principal international travel regulations to insert Regulation 16A, requiring eligible vaccinated arrivals to report the outcome of a day 2 lateral flow device test and to insert Regulation 16B, requiring them to take a confirmatory test from a public provider if the lateral flow test result is positive. Neither the principal regulations nor this instrument specifies confirmatory test should be a PCR test, although the policy note in Scottish Government guidance indicates that the confirmatory test should be a PCR test. Does the committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament on reporting ground H on the basis that the meaning of the instrument could be clearer, that the confirmatory test taken by the eligible vaccinated arrival following a positive day 2 lateral flow device test must be a PCR test? In so doing, does the committee wish to call upon the Scottish Government to amend the Health Protection, Coronavirus, International Travel and Operator Liability Scotland Regulations 2021 to define the term confirmatory test at the next legislative opportunity? No members indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Secondly, the policy note and the letter to the presiding officer which accompany the instrument state that the amended definition of World Health Organization vaccines in Regulation 3 comes into force at 4 a.m. on the 10th of January 2022, alongside the changes to the list of relevant countries which can provide an acceptable vaccine certification in Schedule 1A. Regulation 1 of the instrument provides Regulation 3 came into force at 4 a.m. on the early date of the 7th of January. The Scottish Government confirmed that the commencement of Regulation 3 on the 7th of January is an error. This change should have been implemented in Scotland at the same time as in England on the 10th of January. As a result, it's possible that some travellers may have been classed as eligible vaccinated arrivals in Scotland sooner than intended. The committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament on reporting ground I, on the basis that its drafting appears to be effective. Yeah. No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak. Finally, in this instrument, is in breach of laying requirements in section 32 of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform Scotland Act 2010, which provides that an instrument not subject to the negative or affirmative procedure must be laid before the Scottish Parliament as soon as practical after the legislation is made, and in any event before the legislation is due to come into force. Regulations 1 to 5, 8, 9, 12 and 13 came into force at 4 a.m. on the 7th of January, and the instrument came into force at 9:30 a.m. later the same day. Does the committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament on reporting ground J, basis that it fails to comply with the laying requirements? No members indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Also, under this agenda item, no technical points have been raised on SSI 2022-6, the Health Protection Coronavirus Requirements Scotland Amendment Regulations 2022. This instrument provides for removal of the capacity limits on live events outdoors and removes the requirement for 1 metre physical distancing at outdoor event venues, outdoor exhibitions and outdoor spaces in sports stadia. It also amends the definition of fully vaccinated to introduce booster vaccinations. Pretty content with this instrument. No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Under agenda item number 4, we are considering instruments subject to the affirmative procedure. A number of issues are raised with the Scottish Government on the draft Disability Assistance for Working Age People Scotland Regulations 2022. Firstly, do members wish to report the following 3 errors under the general reporting ground? Firstly, definition of EU withdrawal agreement in Regulation 2 is unnecessary, given that a definition of this term contained in Schedule 1 of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform Scotland Act 2010 already applies. Secondly, that Regulation 17.4b refers to a child in respect of whom a person listed in paragraph 2a has a relationship equivalent to those listed under the Law of Scotland, and should instead refer to paragraph 3a of Regulation 17. And finally, that the definitions of civil partnership, person living with another person, as if they were in a civil partnership in Regulation 17.4, are unnecessary insofar as they refer specifically to same-sex couples on the basis that both same-sex and mixed-sex couples may enter into marriages and civil partnerships. No members indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Secondly, the members wish to report the following 3 errors under reporting ground H on the basis that the meaning could be clearer. Firstly, that Regulation 7.2 relates to how an individual's ability to carry out both daily living and mobility activities is to be determined, and therefore that Regulation 7.2a refer to both the tables at Part 2, that's the daily living activities, Part 3, mobility activities of Schedule 1. Secondly, that the meaning of the term medical treatment, as defined in both Regulations 2 and 16, could be clearer, and that the definition in Regulation 2 could be removed. And finally, that the meaning of qualifying services, Regulation 2, within the definition of residential educational establishments, and in Regulations 27.4 and 5b and 32.3 and 4b could be clearer. No members indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Additionally, do members wish to call on the Government to lay an amending instrument to rectify the errors in Regulations 7.2a and in respect of the term medical treatment, as defined in Regulation 2, before the instrument comes into force on the 21st of March 2022. Furthermore, the members wish to call on the Government to rectify the other errors identified by the committee in that amending instrument. Um, But no members say they are not content or that they wish to speak, and then so we're agreed. Also under this agenda item, no points have been raised on the following draft instruments. The Deposit Return Scheme for Scotland Amendment Regulations 2022, the Registers of Scotland Digital Registration etc. Regulations 2022, the Greenhouse Gas Emissions Trading Scheme Amendment Order 2022, and the Aquaculture and Fisheries etc. Scheme for Financial Assistance Scotland Regulations 2022. Is the committee content with these instruments? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we agreed. Under agenda item number 5, we are considering instruments subject to the negative procedure. Issues have been raised on 3 instruments. First is SI 2021-1455, the Greenhouse Gas Emissions Trading Scheme Amendment Order 2021. Does the committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament on the general reporting ground in respect of the incorrect reference in paragraph 4.3 of the new Schedule 8A, the Greenhouse Gas Emissions Trading Scheme Order 2020, inserted by Article 27 of the instrument, Article 18.11, reallocation regulation, which should have been to Article 18A.11 of that regulation? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Does the committee also wish to welcome that the Scottish Government is liaising with the other UK administrations with a view to correcting this error at the next available opportunity? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. The next instrument where an issue has been raised is SSI 2021-481. It's the Nutritional Requirements for Food and Drink in Scotland, in Schools Scotland Amendment Regulations 2021. Under Section 28.2 of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform Scotland Act 2010, instruments subject to the negative procedure are required to be laid at least 28 days before the committee force, not counting recess periods of more than 4 days. In its letter to the presiding officer, the Scottish Government explained that urgent action was required. Concerns have been raised by education authorities and managers of grant-aided schools about their ability to comply with the duties under earlier regulations as a result of an inability to procure certain foods due to disruption in the school food supply chain. Does the committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament on the reporting ground J, in relation to its failure to lay the instrument in accordance with line requirements under the 2010 Act? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. At the same time, is the committee content with the Scottish Government's explanation provided for the breach of the lane requirement? But no members indicated that they are not content or that they should speak, and so we agreed. A similar issue has been raised on SSI 2021-493, the Official Controls Transitional Staging Period Miscellaneous Amendments Scotland No. 3 Regulations 2021. This instrument relates to the phasing in of border controls on imports of certain goods following EU withdrawal. It breaches Section 28.2. of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform of Scotland Act 2010, which was laid on the 22nd of December 2021, and came into force on the 1st of January 2022. Does the committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament under Reporting Ground J in relation to its failure to lay the instrument in accordance with line requirements under the 2010? No members indicated that they were content or that they wish to speak, and so we agreed. The Scottish Government has provided an explanation of the reasons for the failure in both a letter to the presiding officer and in response to the committee's written questions. All of the committee's correspondence in today's instruments can be found in paper 3 of the online papers. Clearly, there is an issue between the Scottish Government and the UK Government in this particular regard. And with that, I would suggest that we highlight this to the subject committee, where they will be, that they're planning to look at this particular instrument next week. So if we were to highlight this to that relevant committee, so that they can then take any decision that they wish to do as a consequence. Do committee colleagues have any questions or any points on this particular order? Okay. Thank you for that. So no members indicate that they are not content or that we should speak, and so we agreed in that particular course of action. Finally, under this agenda item, no points have been raised on the following instrument, SSI 2021-489. Is the committee content with this instrument? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. And with that, I will move the meeting into private.